Well, to my life, of course, it's gonna be very helpful. I fit Peter for about 22 years, and my right arm, it's really sore, and it's really gonna be big relief. And for Peter, it's gonna be huge independence, because he needed that arm for drinking and feeding, especially drinking. Can you imagine, ask every time you want a sip of water to ask somebody for it? And I think for him, it's gonna be big thing.
You're tied down right now, aren't you?
I am really, because like, you know, 3-4 times a day, he has to be fed, and it's mostly me. My husband helps a bit, but it's still like I'm the main caregiver for Peter, and it's really, you know, tight. Like, you have to come back. You go there for like 2 hours or 3 hours, you have to come back and feed him.
Are you tired?
I am.
Was it a good experience experimenting with that robotic arm?
Yes.
Did it make you feel more independent?
Yes.
Are you frustrated that it costs so much money?
Yes.
So a robotic arm exists. What's preventing you now from getting that arm for Peter?
It's mostly the cost, because the cost is about $30,000, and the government doesn't fund any penny. You have to find money yourself.
That's a problem right now.
That's a problem.
Is it frustrating for you to know that it's out there, but you can't have it right now?
Well, it is, and especially why government doesn't help with the payment. Like, he pay, like, to help with the wheelchair, help with the all other things, and why doesn't government chip in with those things would make the people independent?
What do you want people to know? What do you think that they should help you because it would make you more independent if you had it?
Yes.
Yeah. He just needs one arm. It's going to make the difference in this kid's life. Right, Peter? Yeah.